Ladies and gentlemen, firstly introducing to the blue corner from Poznan in Poland, Sylwester Walczak. And his opponent from India in Cambridgeshire, Tyler Tornado Goodjohn. Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is a welterweight contest consisting of 6 3-minute rounds, kindly sponsored by Diamond Racing. Firstly, introducing into the blue corner, wearing the white and black shorts, today's weighing he scaled 10 stone, 5 pounds and 12 ounces, with a professional record of 6 fights, 3 wins, 2 losses and 1 draw, from Poznan in Poland, let's hear for Sylwester Silvano Walczak. And his opponent in the red corner, wearing the black and gold shorts, at today's weighing he scaled 10 stone, 8 pounds and 6 ounces, with a professional record of 8 fights, 6 wins, 2 losses and no draws, from Ely in Cambridgeshire. Let's hear for Tyler Tornado Goodjohn. Referee Ken Curtis will give his final instructions. 6 3-minute rounds.
Okay, ladies, about the rules. So when I say break, you take a step back. If a boxer goes down, the other one goes to a neutral corner. Defend yourself at all times. Okay, let's shake
hands. Second round, first round.
Well, two of the most different ring entrances, I think you could see. Kevin there from the two fighters, the Tornado, who came in with quite a thumping baseline, and Sylwester Walczak, who, unlike a Tornado, that was more like a Zephyr or a light breeze.
It was a bit Eurovision Song Contest 1983, wasn't it? It was different.
Yeah. I don't think that's the sort of thing to intimidate your opponent, but let's see what he's got in the ring, because that's what matters. The Pole is the one in the white shorts, and he looks like a... slightly taller, more rangy fighter, the 28-year-old from Poznan. Where is the Tornado, Tyler Goodjohn from Ely in Cambridge. Cambridgeshire is certainly more sturdy. And looks like the tougher boxer, you'd have to say. But sometimes appearances can be deceptive. Tyler Goodjohn in the black trunks trying to come forward. He's got good support here as the... home fighters all have had so far. They were making themselves heard as he came to the ring. And Goodjohn at the moment, just sizing up his opponent. But I have to say, Walczak, Kevin, has not been afraid to throw some punches.
He's not, no, he's a big, tall, rangy fighter, be looking to keep Johnson off him. Goodjohn's coming forward, trying to impose himself on the fight. That's a good shot, big right hand over the top.
Great right hand, and Walczak just for the first time in the fight, gave his opponent a target, and Tyler Goodjohn came steaming in. Great right hand. Although Valczak was shaking his head to the referee saying didn't feel it, he certainly did, and he was knocked off his feet. That was a genuine knockdown.
It was a good shot, and it's a shot that Goodjohn's going to be looking for the rest of this fight. Now, he worked the body well, brought the hands down, then brought a sneaky little right hand over the top, landed it perfect.
Well, it's due to go six rounds, but El Tornado might feel that he can get this done in quick time. As he steps forward, the crowd hush here at the Brentwood Leisure Centre as they are absorbed in this fight in the first round. And again, Goodjohn rattles his opponent, who has lost his last two fights and might be carrying some baggage into this one.
It's another one where a fighter could be looking at the next step, though. I was speaking to the Goodjohn team, and they were looking at maybe entering the prize fighter in January, and that's a big tournament to have your eye on, especially when you've got a tricky fight in front of you, and that would have been another thing that could have been sort of on his mind tonight. But he's come out not thinking about anything else other than what's in front of him, and he's doing well.
Heavy
another
blows.
Shot, good shot.
Landing some terrific blows in this first round, Goodjohn. Some real power behind them. And Valczak has got to watch himself, I feel. In his sixth fight, Tyler was stopped by a sharp punch in the fifth round by Vinnie Wolford. And in May, lost the British Masters welterweight title fight on a close decision against Danny Connor. Only blemishes on his record. And at the end of the first round, he can be proud with how that one went, because Valczak was knocked off his feet and took some heavy punishment as well. Let's see some of the best moments. And they came from Goodjohn. Look at that, prodding left jab, just pushing his opponent back and looking to unload, and there's the right over the top. And Valczak was trying to get back to his feet straight away, so he wasn't unduly perturbed by it, but it was a good shot.
It was a good shot. I mean, he's only stopped one in his eight fights, but he turned pro at 19, so it's probably something that he'll develop as he goes in a little bit later now. He's his strength and power. So, you know, a few years later down the line now, he probably start stopping a few more of these opponents. He's looking strong tonight. I like the way he mixed that up. He came down to the body, brought his opponent's hands down, and threw the right hand over the top. That was good. That was clever work.
Signed with Steve Smith originally. Steve Spartacus.
Yeah, you know, he's an all-action fighter as well, and you know, hopefully Goodjohn will be able to sort of carry on that mantle there. And that first round was the first round I'd seen of him, and I was impressed.
Yeah, it's been a good show so far from Goodjohn, who keeps stepping forward and looking to try and catch Valczak with some good blows. And again, you see that right over the top, which Valczak is not defending. Having said that, the man from Poznan has been willing to trade punches, and that's encouraging. But certainly, Goodjohn looks the tougher of the two boxers, and some impressive ink work as well.
Absolutely, yeah. He's sort of could get caught out with a problem that we spoke about earlier on in tonight's boxing, where if you catch the opponent early in the fight, the opponent then goes into his shell a little bit, and you then go hunting too much because you've got that early knockdown, and you do see sort of the red rad to the bull, and you run forward. So hopefully we won't see that in this fight, and Goodjohn just sort of takes his time, relaxes, and lets his big shots go. That was a good body shot again. Good left.
Yeah, he means business tonight. Goodjohn, that was a lovely left to the body. And when you're a fighter like Tyler Goodjohn, do you see a boxer who's slightly more rangy and a bit on the slimmer side, a bit maybe taller, but you must feel that you've got a power advantage?
Yeah, definitely. And the other thing as well is it's always better when you're the shorter opponent. Your opponent being taller is always punching down. So if he's always punching down, if you throw a shot over the top, the opponent's always there. He's always going to be open if he's punching down at you. So it's always a very dangerous position for a taller fighter to be in, as we saw in that first round. He just brought the shot over the top. He could have closed his eyes and looked at the floor, and he would have still landed it. And that's always the danger. So if you're a strong fighter and you're fighting a tall, skinny opponent like he is doing tonight now, he doesn't need to stop you. Sumchil's come out. He didn't need to stop then.
Yeah, he showed respect there, Tyler Goodjohn, but that wasn't incumbent upon him to do so. He could have carried on.
He should have gritted his teeth and landed the biggest shot he could have thrown. You know, that's boxing. You were in there to win. You're not in there to make friends. His gumshoe came out. He stopped and looked to the referee. He should have loaded up and smashed him.
Well, Valczak did acknowledge that was good sportsmanship, but it's not necessarily what you have to do. And again, they come together, the two fighters. A flurry of blows there from Goodjohn. Valczak's been all around the world in the last 15 months. Been to Czech Republic, Poland, Denmark, Canada, and Poland. And he won't have been hit with as many like that.
if he starts opening up now, this will definitely suit Goodjohn. He looks like the stronger fighter in there, and obviously when they're in closer, he'll lose his natural advantage of them big, tall, long limbs. So he'll need to get inside, and that'll suit Goodjohn. Let them shots go, and we might see another knockdown.
If he was dictating the fight, then those blows down onto the top of the head would take their toll, but he's just not been able to get control so far. Threw a big right there, which Goodjohn did well to avoid.
Now, you've got to be very, very, very disciplined when you're a tall fighter fighting a smaller opponent. When you throw that jab, you can't afford to throw it sloppy, and he is throwing it sloppy, and he will get caught with that right hand over the top again. If you're a tall fighter, it's got to be nice and neat. Your shoulders got to be up, your chin's got to be down all the time. You've got to throw it straight down the pipe. You can't afford to throw it sloppy. If you throw that sloppy and that comes back, that right hand's going to follow it.
You don't want to make too many excuses when you lose a fight, but it was said that the defeat against Danny Connor, he did go into that 10-round fight carrying a bit of an injury, but I guess when you're going into a fight, you can't say that afterwards, because if you're fit to fight, you're fit to fight, right?
Yeah, of course, and you know, I do like the fact that, you know, he was very young. He turned pro at 19, and he has taken tough fights. You know, he's not sort of wanted to sort of work his way through, but we're just seeing there on the replay there as Walczak stops, his gum shot comes out and asks the referee to jump in and save him. It's not up to you to sort of wait. You need to carry on. The referee is the only person that can stop the action in there.
Well, I wonder what the discos are like in Poznan, if that's the music that he chose, Sylwester.
Well, if that's the case, I'm staying here in London and not going there tonight, because it was different. It was poor.
Yeah, there could be a big night in Brentwood tonight, because a lot of these fighters have got a lot of supporters down here. And I imagine they'll be looking for somewhere to go on to as the tornado. Tyler Goodjohn comes out for round three. Big night of boxing here tonight at the Brentwood Leisure Centre. Lots to come on this Steve Goodwin night. The earthquake in Essex, as it's been labelled. And look at this. He's throwing some punches.
A bit of ambition here. Yeah, he's been fired up in the corner. He's come out this round looking like he wants to have a trade.
And Tyler Goodjohn has just realised that the fight has not been sucked out of the pole yet. I say yet, it might not be at all. This fight is still in the balance. He's got to make sure he sticks to his principles and keeps trying to land those heavy blows. But in this round, I think Valczak has made the better start.
Yeah, Valczak, he's trying to keep that centre of the ring there. He's been obviously being pushed back there now, but he is trying to keep the centre of the ring and keep Goodjohn on the back foot to stop him being able to propel himself forward and put power in them shots. So he does know how to use a ring. He does know what he's doing in there. He's keeping there the centre of the ring again. That was a nice little body shot.
Interesting clash of styles, isn't it? They are very different.
Yeah, there's a big, big height discrepancy here, and obviously they've got to use their advantages as they need to. But Johnson needs to come forward, keep a nice rolling style, roll his way in with the shots to miss Wallach's nice long shots as he's coming forward. And then they're both doing what they need to do.
And he is bobbing and weaving at the moment. Just covering up there, Goodjohn, but doesn't seem to be too perturbed by the power that's coming his way. He seems to be willing to step in there, maybe take a glancing shot just so he can get inside.
Yeah, when he's in tight, there doesn't look to be a lot of power from Walczak. That's a good left hook.
Yeah, and he just shook his head there, Valczak, as if to say that I felt that one.
Somebody like Walczak, they're big shots, and the ones that you don't want to get caught with is when they sort of throw them nice and long. If he put his nice and his right hand nice and long, nice and straight like a bar, that's when it'll cause you a problem. On the inside now, he doesn't seem to have the power to sort of worry Goodjohn. So Goodjohn needs to get inside, stay inside, and let his shots go nice and neat, nice and tidy around the sides, and throw that right hand over the top.
And there was a really good left in there that shook Valczak, and again, a lovely left from Goodjohn, and he might be able to ram home his advantage here at the end of the third. Three. And this is the third round of six, and Goodjohn at the moment is the man in control of the fight, but Valczak certainly has got a hunger that has not been sated yet in this fight. He really wants to make
shot.
Sure.
That's a big shot on the inside. That hurt him. That hurt him. It was a right hand inside.
Goodjohn, can he finish things at the end of this third round? He's really trying to get inside, but he is wary of that long left jab.
But it seems to be Walczak that wants to come forward, wants to trade on the inside, which is crazy, crazy.
Another flurry of punches from Goodjohn, and the referee is happy for them to trade here. Valczak.
Big cut.
Well, he's throws his arms out as if to say, you haven't hurt me, but he must have hurt him there, Goodjohn. A really good flurry of punches towards the end of that third round.
That's a bad cut.
the problem for Goodjohn is that if that cut becomes worse, then that could affect the vision, but also the referee will have a close eye on it as well.
Definitely. I mean, everybody who knows boxing knows Mick Williams, you know, one of the best in the business. There's a few of the top cutsmen in the country, Mick Williams, Frank Hopkins, and he's got one of them in the corner tonight now, so that'll be a great relief for him to go back to the corner and have him there.
Was there a clash of heads in there, or was that a shot?
Well, they are coming together, and it is, you know, an awkward, scrappy opponent that he's got in front of him, so it can happen, and, you know, it is going to be a clash of heads that will cause a cut like that. But get back to the corner, stay nice and calm, let Mick do his job, and, you know, it shouldn't have a bearing on the fight.
Maybe when they came together there, just towards the end of that round, a cut man can be worth his weight in gold.
That's a good shot.
Oh, massive right from the tornado. And Walczak is trying to cling on there. Brilliant shot at the start of this fourth round, and this has been a really great fight. And look at Goodjohn now. He's looking to finish things. Big right hand. Superb right. And Walczak is desperately trying to hold on now.
This is where you wonder whether he is affected by the cut, whether he's worried about it, and he's thinking, no, I want to get him out of here. Let's not take a risk.
Well, that was two.
There we go again. That's the one. Referee stopped it.
And he will not be getting back up from that in a hurry. What a brilliant shot. There were three crunching rights in that fourth round. And the third one, there was no coming back from. Terrific stuff from Tyler Goodjohn. And now you can see why they call him the tornado.
Big Walczak shot.
He's getting treatment. He's back on his feet, thankfully. Although he's just started to rest himself on the bottom rope. Three absolutely stunning shots there, Kevin.
Three fantastic shots. It's great to see Walczak there. He's sat on his stool now. He's talking back to the doctor because it was a big, heavy knockdown, but it's nice to see. He looks clear in the eyes there. Now he's talking back to the doctor, and it's good to see that.
He showed bravery after the first two shots, but really, look at this from Goodjohn. He had him on the ropes, and there's another big right hand coming up. And the lad from Ely will certainly have pleased his supporters. Here it comes as he gets Walczak where he wants.
That's the shot.
That has really finished him. Clinging on. And there it is, over the top. And it was lucky that Walczak didn't get caught with the second there.
Absolutely.
So Walczak is back to his feet, thankfully, as you can see. Walks over to his opponent to raise
great to
his
see.
Hand. Yeah, great to see. And good to see that Sylwester Walczak is okay. But that was impressive stuff from Tyler Goodjohn, the 21-year-old from Ely, with a great victory.
And after 35 seconds of round four, referee Ken Curtis has deemed Walczak in no position to continue. Your winner from Ely, Cambridgeshire, Tyler Tornado Goodjohn.
A successful amateur who is proving a great success now in the pro ranks. Great performance from Tyler Goodjohn.
Let's have a big round of applause for Gansman all the way from Poznan in Poland, Sylwester.
Thank you, Andy. I tell you what, Mickey, that was the performance of the evening so far.
Without a doubt. I think you picked up straight away, Dom, didn't you? You said, look, you noticed him slipping. And especially against a tall opponent, he slipped that jab beautiful, you know, all night long. And what was impressive, he put him down in the first round, didn't rush it, kept slipping and sliding, looking for the openings.
Shot selection as well, though. I mean, the right that he seemed to keep catching him with, but, you know, he was just so controlled, wasn't he? As well as all the skills that he showed, a great aggression and some power as well.
Without a doubt. And I think, you know, it was a classy performance, you know. And I think, you know, he could have easily, like I said, in the first round, just jumped on him, but he didn't. He took his time, broke him down systematically, and the finish was perfect where he just slips over for that lovely right and over the top. I think, in all fairness, I think the referee might have stopped it, as you said it yourself, maybe the shot
he
before.
He took a heavy shot at the end, didn't he? You just thought he was out of there anyway at that point, wasn't he?
He was, but again, it was a really classy performance.
Well, let's hear from the man himself, because Tyler is ringside, as he's just making his way to ringside, I'm hearing. But anyway, he'll be talking to Sophia now. Is he with Sophia ringside?
Tyler, that was your ninth pro fight. That was an impressive stoppage in the fourth round. Are you happy with that?
Yeah, I'm very pleased. I trained very hard, and you know, I've got to put it all down to my new trainer, Steve Spartacus, as well. He's taught me so many new things and that, and just going through so many different things, and my nutritionist to get my diet right, and I just went in there feeling, honestly, the best I've ever felt in like my whole career. So, you know, I'm over the moon.
I was going to say, that is your first fight together as trainer and fighter. Yeah. So what specifically have you been working on?
Just building my power, varied new shots and things like that, really. But just so much my power. And, I mean, you could see in there, like, as soon as I hit him with the right hand, it was all over the place. So, you know, it's just fights, you know, two or three fights ago, you know, that just wouldn't have been happening, you know. And my nutritionist as well, like I said, I've been making the weight 2 weeks ago and I've been feeling, you know, super strong. So, yeah, I'm over the moon. I really am over the moon. So.
Now, you were outpointed by Danny Connor earlier on in the year. Are you looking for a rematch now after that impressive win?
Yeah, I'd like to. I mean, he's actually gone down in weight. I was light welter, and funny enough, I've just come up to welter like the last year. He's gone down to light welter. I could probably make light welter, and I'd love that. I mean, I've beat him once and he's beat me once. So, I mean, to have it a third time would be brilliant. And I know he wants it because we're good pals and we speak all the time. And he sort of says, you know, like, to have a third one would be brilliant. So who knows, like, it's the future. I'm 21. I just want to build myself up now. And hopefully titles come in 2013. So
brilliant. Congratulations. Thanks a lot for talking.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is a welterweight contest consisting of 6 3-minute rounds, kindly sponsored by Diamond Racing. Firstly, introducing into the blue corner, wearing the white and black shorts, today's weighing his scale 10 stone, 5 pounds and 12 ounces, with a professional record of 6 fights, 3 wins, 2 losses and 1 draw, from Poznan in Poland. Let's hear. Ladies and gentlemen, firstly introducing to the blue corner, from Poznan in Poland, Sylwester Walczak.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And his opponent from India in Cambridgeshire, Tyler Tornell.